So it goes without saying that the adaptive AI powered masks in Lightroom are amazing. I mean, the ability to automatically select a sky or a subject based on the photo, it's mind-boggling. But in this video, I'm going to show you a secret way to select the sky. I don't even think Adobe knows about this, but every single time that I've used it, it has given me way better results when selecting the sky. So I'm going to show you how this works in Lightroom on the desktop, and then I'm going to switch over to the iPad and show you the exact same process, just to show you that no matter which version of Lightroom you use, including Lightroom Classic, if you follow this step, I guarantee you, you're going to get far better sky selections. So let's jump right in. All right, so here's just a regular landscape photo I took several years ago. And the reason why I chose it is because, as you can imagine, doing a sky selection here would be complicated. I don't think anyone would really enjoy the process of having to make a selection around these trees with these very, very complex branches. But that's where the magic of the AI adaptive masks for Lightroom come in. Now, just to show you, if I hit the backslash key, this is the original photo, and then this is what I did. I mean, I think I just clicked on the auto button and selected the Adobe landscape profile. I really didn't do anything else here. The point that I want to show you is the mask tool. And again, this, what I'm gonna show you, works exactly the same in Lightroom, Lightroom Classic, and Lightroom Mobile. So you don't have to worry about it being a little bit different. It's pretty much the same steps. So what I'll do is I'm gonna go ahead and click on sky. And what Lightroom does is it automatically uses AI to identify where the sky is. If I hover over this thumbnail here, you'll see there is the mask. Now, just to kind of indicate to you how I got that really dark mask, if I enable this show overlay here and then click on the little color swatch, you'll see this little flyout menu appear here. And you can choose a few different things. First, you can choose the kind of overlay. So if you want to go on image on black, you can do that. You can do a traditional white on black. This is a traditional mask view. Or you can, in this case here, I'll just do the color overlay for now. The other thing you can do is adjust the opacity of that mask. So if you want just a little bit of a color tint to see the selection, you can do that. But for the purposes here, I'm going to keep it at full opacity. And then I'm going to keep the option here for the affected areas. The unaffected areas would be the inverse. So it basically will show you everything that isn't in the mask, but that doesn't really help here. You could also go for like a different color, but I think this kind of blue over here works well for the purposes. So I'm going to go ahead and let me show you. If I zoom in here, you see just kind of how the mask is bleeding everywhere. Let me toggle the overlay. You see how it's bleeding onto the branches. And if I zoom down here, let me actually zoom out a little bit here. Let me go to 200%. You can see how it's also bleeding here. So the sky selection, while it did a great job, like, listen, this is a really great mask. It still is bleeding on various parts of the image that you may not want to edit. So for example, right now, all we did was we made a selection, but there are no edits made to the mask. So if we went ahead, for example, and started adjusting exposure, not only are we adjusting the exposure of the sky, but we're starting to adjust the exposure of the branches of the tree. And that's something you may not want to do. And here's where the magic comes in. Again, this is something I honestly, I'm not trying to have, you know, an ego about this or anything. I don't know anyone else who's ever shown this way of doing sky selection. I actually included this in a editing video from a while ago, but it was a small part of the video. And I thought, you know what, this is big enough where I'm going to create my own video for this specific thing. So let's jump back in. I'm going to show you how to get an even better selection. So what I'm going to do is go back here and I'm going to create a new mask. I'm going to create another sky mask. So right now, if I collapse these two, they are exactly the same. See, if I hover over, nothing changes. But here's how you make a better selection. What you'll want to do, if it's not already expanded, is you'll click on the disclosure triangle to expand the mask. And then what you're going to do is click on subtract. What that will allow you to do is choose a different selection method to remove or subtract from the selection. Here's where it gets kind of weird, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on select sky. And so what we basically did was we created a mask that selected the sky. And then we said, by the way, subtract the sky that you just selected. And then the last thing that you'll want to do, the kind of magical part, is with this subtract sky 2 layer over here, go to the ellipse, and then go to invert sky selection. Okay, now here's where things get better. So if I hover over here, you see this is the original sky mask that we made. And if I go to this one, look at that. Look how much better that is. If I kind of zoom in over here and I hover over, this is the original. Wow, I mean, it's so much better. Like basically you can see none of the foreground is selected and the selection around the branches is a lot cleaner. So this is the original one and then that's the better one. Kind of see here and it's basically throughout the image. Here's the original and then the better one. I mean, the selection is so much tighter. Now, I don't know why you have to do this. This little kind of jumping through this little hoop here. I don't know why Adobe didn't improve the selection. Maybe they don't even know. So I hope someone from Adobe happens to watch this because this works on every single landscape photo or any photo where there's a sky. So it'll work just as well with a cityscape or an urban photo where you want to have a much cleaner sky selection. It's never failed me before. So that's why I'm so excited to share this with you here. So let me jump back in here for a second and show you something even cooler. So let's say just going forward, you want to be able to have this better sky selection without having to make the sky selection, subtract the sky, and then invert it. I'm gonna show you how you can kind of automate that. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna delete that first sky selection because I don't need that. That was there more just to illustrate to you the improvement. The next thing I'm gonna do is go to the top level of the layer mask over here. Then I'm gonna go to rename and I'm gonna call this better sky mask. Okay, so now I know this is the better sky mask. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna create a preset because here's the thing. You can create presets of adaptive AI powered masks. It is one of the best things that came along with the actual adaptive masks is that you can create these presets. So let me show you how to do that. In Lightroom, I'm gonna go to the preset browser over here, and then I'm gonna go to the plus icon. So I'll just click on plus, and the first thing I'm gonna do is go to select and then go to none. Then when you have nothing selected, go to the masking line over here. You can expand it and you can see there is that mask that we just saved. Then I'll go here, I'm gonna give it a name. So I'll call this Better Sky Mask. And then you can control where you want that preset to be saved. If you have a group already that you wanna save it to, go ahead. For this purpose, I'm just gonna keep it in the user presets and then I'm gonna click on save. Now you can see there is that preset over there under the user presets category. And I'm gonna show you how it works on a different image. So now I'm just going to go over one to this image here. Again, didn't really do anything here. It's just the standard image, but you can see that under masks, there is nothing here. There are no selections made and I wanna create a good mask. So what I can do is go over here to the preset and then go to Better Sky Mask. Now, when I go to the mask view over here, you can see there is our mask and you can see it's a nice clean mask. Typically, when you do a sky selection, especially with landscape photos or with urban photos as well, you will see this kind of fall off or this bleeding onto the actual foreground or onto the actual subject, which may not be desired. This method that I'm showing you will give you a very nice clean mask that you can apply. Now, it's important to note that when I saved that preset just a minute ago, nothing was applied in terms of settings. So if I had made adjustments to any of these sliders or the tone curve before I saved the preset and then I saved it, those settings would be part of the preset. So what I just showed you by keeping everything at zero is basically just an automated way to make your sky selection using my secret method. Now that you have that extra clean, really tight selection for your sky, you can go ahead here and do what you want. So if I wanna go ahead here and make the sky a little bit warmer, maybe add a cool little S curve to the sky to give it a contrast and maybe add a little bit of gray to the black point over there. And then finally, one of my favorite things to do to skies is add some dehaze. Well, now I can do that. But again, because I saved that preset first without any of the settings applied, All I have to do is just select this and the selection will be made, and then I can adjust the sky however I want. And the best part is about the cloud-based version of Lightroom is any preset that you create or import will sync to all of your other devices. So if you have Lightroom on an iPhone or an iPad or an Android device, this preset that I just created will be there so I can have that exact same selection on my mobile devices. Now, before I show you how to do this on the iPad or the iPhone, let me just take a quick minute to tell you about my landscape AI presets. So if you like what you see here, but you're not exactly sure the best ways to stylize your sky or your foreground selections, then definitely check out my landscape AI preset pack. It's a collection of 30 presets, 10 different presets that have sky selections, foreground selections, and then the combo of sky and foreground selections. Each of these presets have been meticulously created, so they're not going to be over the top, and they'll just help you create a better look for your landscape or your urban photos. And the best part is that every single one of these masks already include this improved selection method, so you'll get the cleanest possible results. If you want to check it out, the link's in the description below. It's currently on sale. I think you're really going to love it. And again, your purchase directly helps support my small business. It means the world to me, and it helps me continue making these videos for you. So with that, I want to thank you, and let's jump on to the iPad. Okay, so here we're in Lightroom on the iPad, and I've got my photo loaded. Before I show you how you can apply my secret sky selection method using Lightroom on the iPad, I want to jump into the preset browser, and then I'm going to go to user presets. And you can see there is the Better Sky Mask preset that we just saved on the desktop. So that's one of the coolest things, is that, again, any presets that you import or create in Lightroom will sync to all your other devices. So with this preset here, I can just tap on it and it'll make the better sky selection, but I want to show you how to do it manually first. So what I'm going to do is go to the mask tool over here, and then you can see there is a blue plus button on the bottom right. And if I swipe out, you can see what it is. It says create new mask. So I'm going to go ahead and tap on that, and then I'm going to tap on select sky. So Lightroom detects the sky and it makes the selection with a overlay that you really can't control, unfortunately. Like, you can't control the color or the opacity like you could on the desktop. But we do have our sky selection. Now, what I'm gonna do is, just like on the desktop, I'm gonna tap on the plus again to create a new mask. Again, we're gonna go with select sky. So we basically have two of the exact same masks. And if I swipe out from the bottom right, you'll see kind of this sub panel. So it has more information to show you. And so we're gonna repeat the process that we did on the desktop. I'm gonna go ahead and tap on subtract from mask two, and then I'm gonna tap on select sky, just like before. So effectively we select the sky and we remove the sky. Now, the next thing, if you remember, is we want to invert that remove selection, but it's important to make sure that you're on the right layer. You can see the sky two layer and it has a little minus icon. More importantly, around the thumbnail, you'll see it's highlighted in blue. For example, if I tap on sky one, you'll see now that layer is selected. So we want to make sure that we are on the subtract sky two layer. Now we have to invert. The thing is, if you tap on the ellipse over here, you'll see that there is no invert option. That's because for some reason, Adobe put invert on the bottom left. So if I swipe out over here, you'll see that we have, with the sky two subtract layer still selected, we have invert and delete. So I'm going to go ahead and tap on invert. And now we have our cleaner selection made. So it's a little bit harder to see, if I'm being honest, but watch. I'm going to tap on the mask one over here to enable it. And let's zoom in here. And you'll be able to tell the difference when I select mask two. So watch, when I tap mask two, did you see, especially right around here where the little dot is on the image? If I go back to mask one, you'll see the overlay applied. And then if I tap on mask two, it's removed. So you know that you have a much cleaner selection. So I'm just kind of going back between the two selections here so you can see. Then we can pinch out so we can see the full image. And then if you want, you can go ahead, tap on the ellipse on mask one and delete it. And then if you want, you can tap over here and rename it if you want. But let me show you here. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to delete this improved sky mask. And then I'm going to tap on cancel to get out of masking mode. And now I'm going to go to the presets here and I'm going to tap on better sky mask. Now I'll tap on done. And if I go to the masking tools here, you'll see there is our mask. And because we renamed it before we saved the preset, It now says Better Sky Mask. And with this, you're now free to go ahead. Again, we can go to effects over here and I can add some dehaze. Although this is kind of a boring sky, I can go ahead and cool it off a little bit if I want to. Point is that I have a much cleaner selection with my super secret sky selection method for Lightroom. Again, I'm not exactly sure why Adobe hasn't implemented this. Maybe again, if someone's watching from Adobe, take a look at it. I think it provides a much better experience for users using this not so secret method anymore. And again, if you want a bunch of really great presets that already use these adaptive AI selections for your sky and your foreground and your entire photo, check out my landscape AI presets, links in the description below. If you want to learn even more about how to use adaptive presets, especially with the tone curve, which is just fantastic, check out this link. If you enjoyed this video, a thumbs up is always appreciated. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you'll be notified for new videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.